Welcome to the Dennis and Judi Show on demand. Thanks to our sponsor, Value City NJ, with 9 locations in New Jersey or online at valuecitynj.com. Don't forget to subscribe to the show so you'll never miss a minute. New Jersey
101.5. Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app, New Jersey. Chime time. 10:09. Dennis and Judi Show. I'm Dennis Malloy.
I'm Judy Franco. I was just saying that Kyle was in a bad mood the last couple days.
Yeah.
So now he's calling me a bad mood. So, you know, I decided whenever he's in a bad mood, I'll spend the next day being in a bad mood. seriously, but I am actually in a great mood because I've been talking to you guys about my issues with the Bell's palsy and the synkinesis that developed because of it. You don't know how debilitating it is, and especially on an aging face, because one side of your face is completely different from the other side of the face. So if you don't find somebody to give you the injections that you need, the Botox and everything. So anyway, I find Dr. Monica Tadros. Somebody actually called me on the air, Dennis, to give me her name. But she was in Englewood, and I was like, oh, that's too far for me, blah, blah. I never heard of Englewood. It's New York to me, blah. I'm not going in there. Because it really, it's in Bergen County. I never go up there. Finally, yesterday, I said, I'm going to drive up there. The most beautiful woman I've ever seen, that with this like soothing, beautiful touch, the way she speaks, calming.
What's her specialty? What's her?
She's a plastic surgeon and I think also an ENT. She does a lot of like sinus surgeries, but she also does plastic surgery. Anyway, she, Nancy, who coordinated the whole thing, and Michelle, I told them that I was going to give them a shout out today, but what I really want to say is, if you suffer like I do, and I know a lot of people do, and I bring it up every once in a while, I saw some videos of her doing this online, the injections. Dr. Monica Tadros, please, please, I love her. Go there. She gave me the injections in my eye. Dennis, you never really see me when it's wearing off.
I see you every day, but so I'm so accustomed to.
Have you seen me days where I look like I was beaten up by several Trenton hookers?
Yeah.
Those are the days where the Botox is wearing off.
So
ugly. So, yeah. No, so thank you guys. I love you so much.
Just for background, Judi got Bell's palsy 20 years ago. For most people, it goes away. You never notice anything. And for a handful of people, including Judi, it stayed. And what was the condition you then called it?
It didn't stay. It went away. But when the muscles grew back, when the nerve grew back, because it's all caused by this facial nerve, it grew back having the muscles, controlling the wrong muscle groups.
Okay.
So your brain, when you open your mouth, closes your eye.
So what is that condition called?
It's called synkinesis.
Synkinesis, sorry.
So the Bell's palsy went away. It just, this is what I am left with. So a lot of people have it. People see pictures of me. It's hard being in the public eye. Thank God I'm on radio, not on TV. But when people see me, oh, did she have a stroke or whatever? So anyway, I just wanted to mention that. Now, this morning, I was on my way driving somewhere, and I started skidding a little bit on the road, and my daughter called me in the car, and she heard me going, you know, from the fact that I almost lost control. It's a little icy. And she said, what? And I said, I haven't driven in the snow in a long time. I got to, like, get used to it. And she said, it's snowing?
Where was she?
I go, in Brooklyn. I go, yeah. She goes, I said, it's not snowing there? She goes, not one bit.
Not yet.
I'm like, didn't they call for snow there? She said, no, I don't think. First they said yes, but then they said no. They were just going to get a little bit of rain. So, but there are people in New Jersey getting a lot more than I am. So we want to talk about snow. The phone number is 1-800-283-101.5. We want to basically do a where are you now snow edition, meaning where are you? How bad is it? What's the accumulation near you? And did it affect your day in any significant way? Because I have to tell you, I do have an appointment today after work, and I think I'm going to cancel it. Because until they get to the, start shoveling and stuff, I don't know when that's going to happen. I'm sorry, clearing, I mean. And I get on the, I need to take a bunch of local roads to get this appointment. I think I'm just going to cancel. What are you doing? 1-800-283-101.5. And what is the line where it is by you? Den, I'm guessing where you are, it's pretty much the same as where I am.
No. They're calling for 2 to 5 by me, or 3 to 6 by me, and 2 to 4.
Where you live or where you are right now?
Where I live. And then right at this line here where I'm at, 2 to 4 above.
That's what I was thinking, that it's probably the same where you are, meaning Trenton.
Trenton, yeah.
As and where South I Jersey's am, because I to saw them, you know, make this line across the map, and I said, oh boy, Dennis is in, Dennis has what we have, meaning at the radio station.
Yeah, we're supposed to get a little bit more accumulation in South Jersey than the northern half of the state, only by an inch or two. Driving in, I left really early. I thought it wasn't going to start snowing till 8 or 9 o'clock. So I said, I'll just get up early and I'll beat the... But it was already snowing in earnest by 6 o'clock, and I didn't leave till like 8:15. And I got here like 8 minutes longer than it normally takes me. The roads were like 295 was wet up until Bordentown. Then at Bordentown, the left lane became slushy. Then above Bordentown into Hamilton, all three lanes are slushy. I don't know if it's a matter of it was colder or snowier up here, or the crews were more, since they heard they were going to get more down south, more diligent down south.
Well, I was wondering the same thing. Was it so slippery for me because they didn't salt enough, or is the snow a little different?
I don't know. And here's the other thing. Hats off to the road crews, NJDOT.
God bless you guys.
County road crews, private plow guys who do shopping centers and whatever. Hats off to you. You're doing an amazing job. Thank you for what you do. I noticed, and a couple other people noticed, that they're not brining like they normally do. You know those stripes on the road? Instead, I see a lot of rock salt. Well, Eric was on this morning, and he talked to a transportation guy and said, the brine doesn't work below a certain temperature. So we're going with rock salt. My theory was they have S piles of rock salt from the last 2 years because they didn't use it, so they got to get rid of some of the rock salt. But whatever it is, and the rock salt gives you more traction too.
Well, wasn't there like a time when he was brining? Governor Murphy called for brining, and for like in July.
Yeah, it was March, and it was 45 degrees and rain on forecast. Because he got screwed in one big snowstorm that he wasn't prepared for. So, right. And by the way, you're listening right now, Phil Murphy doesn't like you. This morning, he's on New York and Philadelphia TV and radio talking to the people about New Jersey. This is New Jersey governor. This is the New Jersey radio station. Every governor since the beginning of the station has come on, done Ask the Governor.
I was going to text him this morning, but I lost my nerve.
Yeah, even if it was a contentious relationship with the governor, they would always access our airwaves to tell you what was going on. This guy doesn't like you so much. It's not about spite, and we welcome him with open arms. He doesn't like us because he doesn't like you. The listeners of this station see through his nonsense and don't like his policies. So because he doesn't like you, he won't come on to address you on the biggest radio station. He'd rather do it from New York and Philly. It's shameful and disgusting, but that's who he is. Okay.
I wonder if he's on News 12.
He does do Ask the Governor on there.
Yeah, but is he on there saying, watch out? Because that would be unusual for him not to be on News 12.
Oh, he probably is. I don't have it on right now, but I'll turn it on and see. A lot of people want to give the conditions. I can't wait. We got Branchburg, Kenilworth, Edison, Parkway. And you want to check in on what it's like where you are. And conditions will worsen through the day, so we'll get a real-time accurate depiction of what's going right now. 1-800-283-1015 is the phone number. 10 minutes. So we're asking what the conditions are like by you in this snow day. And also, if you have something planned today or that you already canceled or that you are wondering whether or not you should cancel, like Judy has an appointment after work, it's close to your house, I would say go.
Yeah?
Yeah.
245?
Yeah. Just don't drive like a knucklehead. So if there's something you're deciding whether or not to go to, Judy and I will help you. 1-800-283-101.5. Let's go to Michael in Branchburg. Hello, Michael. Hey, how are you, sir?
I'm good. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. We are out in Branchburg, New Jersey. We are at work at Sublimation 101. The snow is just starting to come down very light. Roads are clear. DPW, like you said before, did an amazing job. Everybody be safe today. But I did notice something to share with everybody, if you don't mind.
Well first, please, can you tell us what Sublimation share. Station 1?
Sublimation 101.
What's that?
We are manufacturer, distributors, importers of how to take images, photos, and logos and put them onto mugs, shirts, mouse pads instantly.
Okay.
Been doing it for 30 years. Love what I do.
Very good.
Thank you. Thank you for asking.
You're welcome. Well, I didn't know what Sublimation 101 was.
Oh, yeah.
I thought he was insulting us, actually.
I thought it was
insulting. No, I'm not.
I thought he was referring to the radio station. Okay, go on.
So maybe we'll go into business and try to compete with you, and we'll be Sublimation 101.5.
Yep. Why don't we just go in business together? There's plenty for everybody.
So what
your knowledge, my knowledge, teamwork makes the dream work.
What did you want to bring up, Michael?
Well, first of all, thank you guys for everything. You guys are great. I love calling in all the time.
Stop
I love taking my, you guys taking my calls. No, I do, and I love it. I want everybody to be careful out there today. The funniest thing, though, I have to share with you last night. I take my better half to. She goes, we go to ShopRite. I said, I'll wait here. She needed a couple of things. No, milk was not one of them. But I'm sitting in the parking lot, and I'm watching everybody come out. Bread and gallons of milk. If I had a dollar for every gallon of milk I saw in 20 minutes waiting for her, I'd have $100, easy.
Yeah, I haven't bought milk in years.
I don't understand that so theory.
I don't know. I had bread and milk.
But I do have a comment for you and something else you said about Governor Murphy, if I may.
Yeah.
He sweats you. He sweats you guys because you speak the truth about our state. You're dedicated to our state. He sweats Bill Spadia. I'd sweat him too if I were him.
And
All of you, because you're honest people.
Well, thanks for saying that, Mike. And
you like honest viewers, and that's what your station's about,
and
honesty.
To be a stand-up guy, thank you for saying that. To be a stand-up guy, you could put that aside for times like this when there's a state of emergency, and nobody's going to trash him when he comes on to tell the people what the conditions are in the state of emergency. But no, doesn't even have the nerve to do
that. Hold on 1 second. Yeah. Hold on 1 second.
And my coworker has his number, and she won't even text him.
Give me the number. I'll call him right now, all three of us on three-way. Come on.
I got to say something really, though,
Please do this,
because I mentioned it the last time we talked about this. I don't think it's appropriate for me to reach out to him for this, but I don't know why our news staff doesn't, and I bet you if they did, he would be happy to come on.
All right. We'll see. I'll speak to them today and see if there has been. I'm sure there's been contact. Michael,
thank you.
We got to run, but thank you, Michael.
Maybe 10 years ago when he became governor.
No, well, the
25 years ago when he became governor.
Well, the little inside baseball, the person in charge back there is a big fan of him and his party.
That's why I'm saying. I guarantee you if one of those people, well, maybe not, you know, when he first came on the radio station, Eric Scott was interviewing him. And Eric Scott can be intimidating. He's scary.
But he was very fair. Anyway,
whatever. But don't you think if Annette called them, our news director,
yes,
who, you know, kittens, she's kittens. That's how sweet and adorable she is, right?
Right.
He's going to say no to kittens?
I don't know. I think so. Stanley in Kenilworth, hi.
Hey, Dennis and Judy, love the show.
Thank you.
Listen to you every day. I listen to you guys.
Thank you.
Good topics.
Thank you.
I'm in Cranford right now from Kenilworth, but I'm in Cranford. Just coming down light flurries and up and off, like dusting, like fine dust. I don't even need the windshield wipers on.
Wow. Yeah, see, the southern part of the state's getting it, had been getting it much harder and faster since about 6:30 this morning.
The roads are clear. They're salting up here, but nothing really to speak of.
That's good news. All right. Thank you, Stanley. Thanks for that. Giselle's in Edison. Hi, Giselle.
Hi, guys. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. Thank you. I'm over here in Edison, Route 1 and 9, heading towards, like, North Brunswick, and it's coming down now. Earlier it wasn't. Roads are clear, but it is coming down now. So be safe out there.
All right. Are the roads...
Okay, thank you.
Is it sticking to the roads?
No, the roads are clear. No sticking.
All right, very good. Where are you going today, Giselle?
I'm shopping. I'm out shopping.
You got kids?
Yeah, I do have kids. I have a 2-year-old and an 8-year-old, and they're home. Thanks.
Thank you. Stay safe. Stay safe. Good mom. Thanks, Giselle.
So what we're trying to do here is kind of take the pulse of all New Jerseyans and find out where it's good, where it's bad, where it's getting worse. Not that, you know, it's funny. It's not like Dan Zarro doesn't give you the complete weather every time he comes on. But it's, I find it interesting to have our listeners out there embedded in it and to give us what's going on throughout their day. Tom on the Parkway. And so if you want to call in, we'd love to hear from you. 1-800-283-101.5. Hi, Tom. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, good morning, guys. Big fan of the show here. Big fan of Bill. I just came down from New York City heading towards Oceanport, New Jersey, where I live. Garden State South is in great shape, past the salt spreader, putting some good salt down. Everyone was honoring the speed limit to a certain extent. And I'm about to stop in Shrewsbury here at Uncle Giuseppe's, pick up some cheese and a bottle of wine, and I think I have a afternoon date with the missus.
Wow.
A little Italian food, a little vino, and the missus? It sounds pretty good.
You know, instead of the cheese and the bread, you go with the wine and the cheese, or the milk and the bread.
Right. Gotcha. All right. Thank you, Tom. You know, it's
that would be your cheese and your meat, your bread and milk.
Yes, right, for me. You got Lavoti's, you got Uncle Giuseppe's. These are Italian superstores, like Walmarts of Italian food. What? No other part of the country has that.
I don't.
And then you also got.
I find it more like the Whole Foods of Italian.
Okay, and then you got Joe Leone's. There's another one, and then there's big specialty stores. You got the Dolce and Cabana over there in Robbinsville. No other part of the country. Like, can you imagine that in Ohio?
Dolce and Gabbana?
No, Dolce and something else.
Oh, okay, because I'm like, those designers have branched
right, no,
out
Dolce
into
and something. Clemente. Dolce and Clemente in Robbinsville. All right, so what are the conditions like where you are? And is there something you were thinking of maybe not doing to canceling today? Well, Judy and I will help you say, now you should go. 1-800-283-101.5, 1030.
Now, the latest...
What the hell are we doing here? Let's move to Florida.
Yeah, except for there is something about snow sometimes.
I know. It's part of...
Do you feel it?
Living here. Yeah, it's just a...
I don't like freezing cold, but there's something about, like, when I was out in snow today, I was like, oh, this sucks. But, like, looking out the window, it's pretty.
It's just having two commutes that are, like, treacherous. This morning wasn't treacherous. On the way home, a little more concerned. It's just, and on a day like this, I could use the technology and do it from home.
You could also use a boss who would pay for a hotel room.
He offered to. I just thought the snow was going to start a little later than it did. So, and I'll figure, why waste it? But it wasn't that bad driving in. Let's find out what it's like around the rest of the state. And do you have something later today that you're thinking, I don't know? Judy and I will help you decide. Dominic's in West Berlin. Hey, Dom.
Hey, Dennis and Judy. So I'm out in West Berlin. 73 is not too bad, but the side streets are pretty slick.
Now, in your area, are the local crews spreading salt?
On the main roads, absolutely. Yeah. 73 is quite clear right now.
Good.
But the side roads, once again, like I said, they are treacherous now. They're very slippery and slide.
Even some towns have done a pretty good job at salting. And like I said, you didn't see much brining this year where they had those stripes of salt on the road. It's a lot more rock salt. Either they're trying to get rid of the rock salt they didn't use in the last 2 years, or it's too cold for the brine to be that effective. But the rock salt also gives you a little traction. I thought 295 was great up until about Bordentown, and then it got a little tricky.
Yeah, I'll be out here all day delivering pizzas in this weather, so I better be careful.
Who do you work for?
Small pizza shop on Route 73 in Jackson Road called Roma's Pizza and Stellato Ristorante.
Jackson.
And we'll be open all day.
Right near that Speedway place?
Right next to the music place, and there's a new business that opened up, Catty Corner Tug.
Oh, okay.
Tractor Supply.
Roma's Pizza. All right. I know where you are. Across from where the lumber yard used to be.
Yep, the old 84 lumber. Yep, absolutely.
All right, well, good. Stay safe.
Absolutely.
And thanks for chiming in, Dominic. Appreciate the call. Yeah, I was thinking of getting a pizza delivered today, and I thought, are people going to deliver? I think so, right?
Why not? Yeah. People rake it in today, delivery people. 100%.
The problem is, I have Kyle order the pizza.
Uh-huh.
And he's like...
He's not good at ordering?
No, he's great. He does it, and he's quick, and he's in it, and again. But he gives him, like, $30 tips. I tipped a guy $30, hope you don't mind. Because I give him my card.
Right.
And I'm a good tipper, but I think he goes a little crazy.
Hmm.
Barry. So what's it like by you, your conditions? And do you have anything today that you're questioning whether or not you should go? Judy and I will help you. 1-800-283-101.5. Barry's in Robbinsville. Hey, Barry.
Good morning, guys. Barry, New Jersey traffic north, heading up the New Jersey Turnpike. It's actually getting better.
Yeah, it's getting better. It's worse in the south. It's worse in the south with this storm than up north. So where are you? What exit around are you now?
I'm just about to hit exit 11 by the parkway, heading up to Mount Kisco. But it definitely is clearing up. It's clearing up, but it's definitely a lot lighter than where we are down by Dolce Clemente.
Yes.
By the way, Judy, the hookers in Trenton say their apologies. They thought you were someone else.
Love this guy.
Barry, you win. You win.
Barry, where do you get your pizza in Robbinsville?
Di Lorenzo's is like the place, as you know.
If I lived there, I'd be at Massimo's.
Massimo's is also great.
Yeah.
Also fantastic pizza, but, you know.
You are in the hot spot. You're in the hot spot in New Jersey of good pizza places.
We are. We really, really are. So, and anyway, have a good weekend, guys, and happy gefilte fish to you both.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
All right, Barry. What's it like by you, and do you have anything today that you think questioning whether or not you should go? Judy and I will help you with that. 1-800-283-101.5. This is real-time conditions. This is not like, well, I think in another hour it should be. This is, bam, what's it like right now?
That's right. And Barry, as a spokesperson for the Trenton Hookers Association of America, I did not know they even had a spokesperson, so it seems that everybody has a spokesperson now and then. I think they should go stand in solidarity with those students, those pro-Hamas students at Rutgers.
Yeah. And same level.
Same ilk. Anyway, Jesse in Freehold, you're on New Jersey 101.5. Hello.
How's it going?
Good.
So I'm on Sharon Station Road. I don't know what town, but it's not plowed. It's not brined. Everyone's fighting on ice and snow over here.
It is bad, Dennis. I mean, he's in my general neighborhood, and they did say that Monmouth County, southern Monmouth County, would be bad. It's bad.
What area? So are you in the Freehold area, Jesse? Jackson?
I'd say about that, but like the Union Transportation Trail Parking Access.
Okay.
Over by Herbert Ave and Sharon Station Road intersection.
All right, and it's just untouched. It's slippery and treacherous.
Yes, sir. I mean, this morning when I drove down this way, because I had to go to Atlantic City to do something important, which got canceled because of the snow.
All right. Well, stay safe, Jesse. Just use common sense. I saw people in the left lane that was slushy, while the middle and the right lane were just wet, going faster in the slushy left lane to get ahead of everybody. That stuff is so uncertain. The surface is so unpredictable.
But people think slush is wet.
Yeah, but just...
So they think it's safer. They don't realize that there could actually be ice under there.
And that there was a guy in the ditch, in the median today. Every time it snows, somebody ends up in the median ditch because of it. Mark and Gary, you got Hillsborough and Colts Neck. We'll find out what it's like over there.
Slush could be very tricky. That's the awareness we're trying to bring here. Slush, right. Tricky.
Thank you, Judy. It's 10:44. We'll have fast traffic and your call coming up, and I have a question. Do you or a parent find it difficult to step over your bathtub to take a shower? Well, your worries are over. Dennis Malloy here, and I want to tell you about the Tub Cut, which converts your tub into a walk-in shower. Without costly renovation, it's custom fabricated to your needs, and it's completed in just half a day. It's even reversible for when you go to sell your home, if you like. Just a 4-inch step. No more struggling to get in and out. You avoid serious injuries with improved safety and accessibility. My parents had something like this done, and it was life-changing. Now, it's less expensive and less intrusive. Call them today. Great people, 877-TUB-CUTS, or log on to TUBCUT.com. Improvement from the app chat, a couple of messages today. Hi, D and J, just sitting home on my 57th birthday. Can't tell you how many snowy birthdays I've had. We'll relax until it's time to shovel. So glad you guys are on the air today, though. Nothing better on my birthday than enjoying my two favorites. Be careful driving home, Dennis. We need you. Oh, nice.
Aww.
Hi, D&J. I'm in Hillsboro. It's been snowing since 8 a.m. It's coming down pretty good now. That's from Allison in Hillsboro. And Donna says we're driving up from Lewis, Delaware to Watertown, New York. It says Watertown, New Jersey. There's a Waretown, New Jersey, and there's a Watertown, New York. Well, the roads seem fine. You guys are the best. Well, I'm glad to hear that, Donna. Angela, grilled cheese and tomato soup. Oh, that was a Bill Spadia comfort food question answer from this morning.
I'm glad you brought that up. That is a really good comfort food.
I've never had that combination.
I gotta make some.
That sounds so good. Delish. Gary in Colts Neck. Hi.
Hey, good morning, DJ, JD. Hey, listen, is it really your birthday today?
No, I was reading a app chat message from a Susie in Hilltown.
All right. Well, anyway, you know, I didn't plow for 2 years, you know. Now, everybody, I'm everybody's best friend now. It's crazy.
Sure.
You know, and you know what? I love people, but here's the problem. Last week, we had the little storm. It got so cold and icy. I had people tell me, Gary, you don't have to come. Well, it froze up like an ice rink. And now they want me to come there. And you know what? You didn't get any jobs last year done. You saved money. I don't understand people. People, listen, be careful of the black ice under the white snow. Because let me tell you something. I almost bit it before at my yard. It is so slippery underneath. But the main roads here in Colts Neck, Farmingdale, Howell, I got to tell you, kudos to all the hardworking people out there.
I'm glad you're saying that, Gary, because that's like my husband's route home from work. And I have been worrying about his driving home. He's driving in that little Tesla. It's not like it has four-wheel drive,
right.
You know?
Well, the public works departments of towns and the county and the NJDOT doing a great job. Gary, thank you. Stay well. Stay safe. Appreciate the call. And again, Governor Murphy on radio and TV in Philly and New York today. Because he doesn't like you. Nobody here. I mean, he doesn't like us either. But if he liked you, because he knows our listeners are the heart and soul of New Jersey, but he doesn't like you, so he's not going to bother coming onto your radio station to tell people. It's disgusting. For a leader, that's not a leader. That's a rich guy who bought a seat that he knew he could buy on his way to whatever else.
Did anybody doubt that then?
No, but it's glaringly apparent. Like I said, I don't like the man at all, and it's personal because of what he tried to do to us. But if he calls it, can I come on and give of course, and without commentary, without editorial anything, just yes, sir, come on, the governor's here, here's the message, thank you for coming on. Boom. You don't even have the decency to do that?
But again, and I'm not trying to defend him then.
Yeah, you
are. Do we know that he was asked?
He doesn't need to be asked. It's New Jersey's radio station. Doesn't need to be asked. Was he asked by ABC? Was he asked
Do you think he knows? Well, first of all, yeah, he was probably asked by all those stations. But
I think he puts out the word. I'm coming on because I want to tell the people of New Jersey from the outside what's going on in the state. It's disgusting. Sorry. Okay. I know he's your boyfriend, but...
Well, not only boyfriend, but
Mary.
I prefer to think of it.
Mary in Bucks County, what do you got?
So coming out of Bucks County was fine. I did Route 1 and 195 East into Jackson, and they have done an amazing job on 195. It's just wet. I'm actually at the just pulled into the Jackson Premium Outlets, which are open, and parking lot's in good shape.
Well, how
everything's
well,
open.
Really
I don't think there are businesses that are
just snowing. Monmouth Road was. I did Monmouth Road for a little short stint, and that was fine.
537. Yeah, very good, Mary. Thank you for that. That's gets all the way clear across the state from Bucks County into Jackson, almost across the state. Very good.
But it is a little slippery near me. That's all I'm saying. Be careful. And I'm talking about coastal Monmouth County.
Right.
It's just a little bit slippery. And this is the weather that makes people sometimes feel like they're in more pain. It exacerbates pain. And if you are in pain, I don't get it. There's Trinity Rehab, people. Why are you not walking around pain-free? You haven't called them. Here's the phone number, 800-518-0977, or go to trinity-rehab.com. Remember, Trinity has EPAT. EPAT is something that we've all used here. I've used it. Dennis has used it. It's an acoustic pressure wave therapy. For most people, 3 5-minute sessions is all you need to be completely out of pain. Not only that, but they have same-day appointments. You don't need a prescription to get started. It's unlike any other facility of physical therapy you've ever seen. Plus, not only are they in network with Aetna, but they're also now fully in network with Blue Cross Blue Shield, which could make a huge difference for a lot of people. Call them today for your same-day appointment. It's never been easier because they're all over the place, like Somerville, Howell, Hamilton, Woodbridge, Wall, and the newest locations, Piscataway and Summers Point. So you know there's one near you. For more details, visit trinity-rehab.com.
Clark's Casino and Sportsbook, New Jersey. Chime time is 11:09. It's Dennis and Judy Show. I'm Dennis Malloy.
Hello, I'm Judy Franco. Welcome to the program. It's funny, my husband just showed me a picture of this yesterday, Dennis, at his very, very good friend's house was prominent in Brooklyn in The Godfather because it was, what's his name's house? It was...
Don Corleone?
Don Corleone's house. And he said, and it was supposed to be Staten Island, I think, but it was actually that, like they showed Staten Island landscapes right around it, but that house was actually in Brooklyn. Anyway, that house has not changed. The house looks exactly the same as it did. It's probably was built in the 20s, 30s. And today, when you drive down that street in Brooklyn, it's the same exact house. And so, of course, the people who live there are always like, oh, our house was in the... This is not it?
Yeah.
Isn't that happening? Yeah. Why are you volunteering?
I almost fainted.
Why?
Just kidding.
I'm like, I'm on the rock. This is not what we're supposed to talk about?
No, I was just waiting to jump in and say, well, the reason this is pertinent is that at the 2024 Sundance Film Festival this year, 7 films were shot in Jersey.
That's amazing because New Jersey gives them a lot of tax breaks. And anytime they can, they'll shoot in Jersey. It's also very close to Manhattan, which means that they can run back and forth and back and forth. And so that's a film center in and of itself.
And it's cheaper, I guess, to shoot here, especially if you're getting tax breaks. And I don't know if the union is as big here, but you can't move a rack of clothes in New York without, you know, paying the union.
Oh, boy, that's for sure. Okay, so 1-800-283-101.5 is our phone number. We're wondering, when was it that some place near you was featured in a movie or a TV show, some New Jersey spot that had its 15 minutes of fame because it was in a movie or a TV show? 1-800-283-101.5, your house, your car, your mother's laundromat. My mother's home in Deal was actually in a movie, in a low-budget movie that a friend of mine made for $2 million many years ago with Susie Essman and Artie Lang. It was called What's Your Sign? And not only...
Did you ever see it?
I've seen it 100 times. And my mother is actually in it.
Really?
She got a bit part, yep.
Is it worth... Where can I find it?
I don't know. But my best friend is the producer and the director, so I could probably get it. It used to be shown sometimes. It was in a lot of festivals, and it used to be shown on airplanes.
Remember one time we asked, what was your connection to The Godfather? And
yeah,
it blew up, I think, 2 hours worth of people saying...
All those people are dead now, unfortunately.
It was filmed in, what, 72, 71?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
But it was really, really like everybody was somehow related to Godfather. 1-800-283-101.5 is our phone number. I get excited when I see, like, every once in a while I would see in The Sopranos, they would show, like, the night, not the nightclub, but didn't What's Her Nuts have, like, her own...
The Bada Bing?
Not the Bada Bing. She had her own bar.
Who?
You know, I can't think of her
Carmella?
Name. No, the girlfriend, Michael, what's his name's girlfriend?
Michael Imperioli's girlfriend?
Yeah. Adriana,
there you go.
Was it?
Yeah.
And that building is in Long Branch, and I see that building all the time. And it's always cool to me.
Yeah, like when the Striali's pork store, or there's other scenes that people recognize from the Sopranos that I have never seen or weren't familiar with. But the last time we talked about it, I said, nothing's filmed where I grew up in Delran. It's like nothing shot there, nothing in Marlton. And a guy wrote in or called and said, oh, yeah, there's this movie, that movie, and the other thing. Even the small little towns you don't think anything was filmed there, people who know this stuff will tell you, oh, yeah, there was quite a bit filmed there. He named three or four things that were shot in Delran. I was like, what, when, why, where? Mary is in Point Pleasant. Hi, Mary.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm good. I heard you and Judy on the radio, and I just wanted to chime in. They're going to be filming a movie starting March 30th at New Egypt Speedway. My husband and I acquired the Speedway back after my in-laws owning it for 12 years, and we took possession back last year, and someone had approached my husband about doing a movie. It's called Pony. If you go on Pony Official, you'll kind of see the feed on Instagram, but it's about dirt modified racing, two champion sisters, and it brings awareness to fentanyl as well.
Oh, wow. And it's called Pony.
So, now, are you doing this for the money? Because I understand you don't get paid a lot. Like, we did it for my friend, because he was my friend. He didn't pay us, but he ended up fixing a lot of things in our house for free, which was great.
That was nice.
We're accommodating whatever they're asking for. On a filming day, they said it will be anywhere from 250 to 300 staff and crew. And they'll film on the days that we are not racing, mostly midweek. But they are going to take footage during the Saturday night shows. And that will... That'll bring a lot of awareness to the sport. You know, lately everybody's been watching it from Flow Racing or Dirt Digest. You subscribe and you could watch, but they'll get to be extras in the movie. My own son is driving the stunt car for the pony car because he's a driver.
How cool is that? When does it start filming, in March or May?
March 30th. And if you guys want to come, I could put you on my friends and family. And
oh,
you
know, that's so sweet.
Let me ask you a question, unrelated.
I think we should, Dennis, represent the radio station.
I would love that. Are you?
Yes, we'd love it.
Did you ever go to eat at the Ark in Point Pleasant?
Yes, it's right down the road from my house. It's amazing.
Yeah, because I think my friend who owns the place mentioned that you've been in there a few times. Yeah.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I'm on my way. Jim Murdoch, who I hear you mention, he's our video guy. My husband gave him his first job out of college.
Wow, really? How cool is that?
He's a close family friend. As a matter of fact, I'll be spending the night and the day with him. I'm on my way to the Motorsports Expo in PA. The pony car's there. We'll give out schedules. Drivers will buy their parking spot and all that. So we'll be there. I believe it's 2 to 9 tonight. There's also a Miss Motorsports pageant, which is a great hit with all of the guests.
Miss Motorsports.
I would love to see. I'd love to be the MC of that.
I really want to be in the Miss Motorsports. Can I be in that?
Mary.
I got to judge it 1 year, and it was amazing. And you get to do, like, backstage interviews. So much more goes into it than you think.
Very good. All right, Mary, thank you so much for giving us the heads up. Another film being shot in New Jersey coming up this spring. Thanks, Mary. Good luck at New Egypt Speedway. That's awesome.
That's adorable. So who else has had a home or a property or a car and I keep saying car because a lot of people have, if you own a classic car, a lot of times people use your car in their movies and films.
That's what came up when we talked about The Godfather. A couple of people say, yeah, my uncle's car. You know the scene when they use my uncle's car.
In fact, I just read about a lawsuit. Somebody's family is suing Bruce Springsteen because they lent him... their dad's car.
I saw that.
To use for an album cover or something. And I'm like, you know, your father's dead. He's probably spinning in his grave right now that you're doing this. He was probably thrilled to have his car on Springsteen's album, and you're going to sue him for... I forget the whole story, but...
I remember seeing it about a month ago. Bottom line,
it was like one of these like money-grabbing things I felt. And I was just like, let your dad rest in peace, you know, with his classic car.
Yeah, they probably see him. He's got lots of money. He, you know, he should have paid dad for that. Like you said, the dad was probably thrilled to use the car. I don't know.
Yeah.
We don't know what promises were made or whatever, but...
We don't, but it's just dumb. Anyway, so what have you... What TV or movie, TV show or movie had used a senior... Why can't I speak?
And, I don't know.
Used a New Jersey scene near you or part of you. 1-800-283-101.5. Are we going to take Nick? You want to go to traffic?
Let's go to traffic.
All right. 11:18. Here's New Jersey Fast Track.
So 7 New Jersey films appear at the Sundance Film Festival this year. 7 films that were shot in New Jersey. Your Monster is one of them. Depicts a depressed woman who returns home to find the monster that lived inside her closet as a kid is still alive and well. Filmed in East Orange, General Hospital, and various locations in Elizabeth, Hoboken, and Newark. I saw the TV Glow. Is a horror film, follows 2 teenagers who bond over their love for a scary television show that gets mysteriously canceled. Filming locations, Verona and Cedar Grove High Schools, The Saint in Asbury Park. Is that a club?
Ooh. Yeah, my sons played there.
Yeah. Keensburg Amusement Park, Funplex in East Hanover, Pump It Up in Roselle Park, Camp Lewis in Rockaway. Boy, so that movie's called I Saw the TV Glow. So they filmed everywhere. And there's I tell you,
it's there's a lot every day pretty much. You could report that there's another movie filming here.
You could make any kind of movie. You'd find a location for it in New Jersey, really. With the varied landscape that we have. From the 100%. Ocean to the mountains to cities.
Every era, every time period.
Yeah.
We'll give you colonial.
Yeah.
We'll give you little renaissance here and there.
Right. We'll give you upscale swanky. We'll give you decaying urban.
Beverly Hills.
Yeah.
We got everything.
So what was filmed by you?
Can't do that in Idaho.
There you go. Rocks. You got rocks. You're making a cowboy movie.
A movie about rocks? Go right to Idaho.
And cowboys.
Anything else, you got to do it in Jersey.
All right. So what was filmed by you or in your area, TV show or movie? Nick in Forked River. Hi.
What's up, guys? Back in the 90s, I let a buddy of mine borrow my white Ford Bronco.
Mm-hmm.
And it was all over the news for like, I don't know, a couple hours. It gave me a lot of good publicity, though. So
that wasn't a movie. It was just a TV show?
Yeah.
Was that That's news story? Nice. That was your Bronco?
Yeah.
Also, let me tell you something interesting about your Bronco, Nick. There was something wrong with it. It didn't go very fast.
Yeah. Did you have a regulator on there, a governor?
Yeah, there was a problem with one of the injectors. So, you know, otherwise, I think you would have got away.
Now, normally, you'd be working, you know, power washing buildings, and today, because of the weather, you're not, right?
Right.
No, I'm laying in my
radio station, making funny jokes.
Well, I was going to ask, did you start drinking early or smoking early or what's happening?
No, I'm just laying in my plow truck waiting to get my salter fixed.
Oh, okay. All right. So. Very good. Thank you, Nick, for the call to New Jersey 101.5. And that wasn't shot in Jersey anyway. That Bronco?
No, that was right. That's true. That was somewhere in Los Angeles,
yes.
I believe.
Debbie, do you remember his friend's name who was driving him around? OJ's friend?
Al Cowlings.
Is that who it was? Yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah. Oh, I thought you knew.
No, it's just...
I'm pretty sure it's Al Cowlings, AC.
Who was also a former football player? I think so.
Yeah. That was like his BFF. My daughter's birthday. I know it was June 12th. That's the only reason I remember.
I wonder if Kyle was aware of the white Bronco chase. Because he said...
Oh, it was way before he was born.
Yeah. So I wonder if that reference is lost.
Oh, because he said he wants to make a joke about a Ford Bronco.
Right.
Did
Kyle?
He understand
I understood it,
it
right away, yes.
Oh, you did? So you're aware of the...
Saw the People versus O.J. Simpson TV show. I was very fascinated by that for a while. Actually, when I was in high school, we did, like, I was in a criminology class, and the O.J. case is, like, the first thing they talk to you about.
Wow.
How funny that, like, for him, it's history. Yeah, and, like, it was, like, a couple years ago I watched the news. TV.
If the glove don't fit.
Yeah, very good. You probably know more studying it than most people who watched it live.
I loved that case. It was very, very cool. Yeah. Well, I mean, not cool, but it was interesting.
It was. It was fascinating. Thanks, Kyle. All right, Debbie is calling from Tom's River. Hello, Debbie.
Hey, how are you guys doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. So the street I grew up on, Franklin Avenue in Harrison, New Jersey, was in the opening scene of The Karate Kid, the original movie.
Oh.
Supposedly, well, this doesn't have a good reputation, but our street was called the Ghetto in Harrison. And apparently, I guess the Karate Kid was leaving his town, and all the people who grew up on the street were out there. I think there's even a shot of my mom on the street.
Wow. How cool is that? What street? What's the name of the street?
Franklin Avenue in Harrison, New Jersey.
All right. Very good. Thanks, Debbie. Appreciate the call. Even if it's not so flattering, lots of stuff was shot here in Jersey. What was shot by you? Frank's in Rumson. Hello, Frank.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Great. How are you?
Good, good. So I'm calling about two different films, actually. A friend of mine wrote, produced, and starred in both of them. One of them is called Rushed, R-U-S-H-E-D. It's about fraternity hazing. And 95% of that was shot in Monmouth County, most of it in Rumson, some of it on my street. I'm actually in a scene for about 5 seconds or so. She also did a movie called Shelter in Solitude, a little bit in Jersey, mostly in New York, but they're both out on streaming right now. Shelter in Solitude just came out, and Rushed has been out for a bit. But again, Rushed is almost completely in New Jersey and most of it in Rumson and surrounding areas.
Yes.
Say that again, Judy.
Are they going to be like big movies?
One's been out a bit. Rushed has been out. You know, they had a decent budget. They're very well done. They're getting pretty good receiving scores on, like, you know, Rotten Tomatoes and IMDb.
That's cool.
I've seen them, obviously, but they're both really kind of excellent. They had a director from overseas, actually, from Denmark, I think. Who directed them? You know,
those Denmark directors.
All right, thank you, Frank. Thank you for that. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5.
Yeah, I think there are a lot more movies that have been filmed in New Jersey, in and around New Jersey, than we even know, and TV shows. So that's why I may have never heard of them. But please let us know what's been shot near you, movie TV wise. Because we don't know them all. 1-800-283-101.5. Your phone call's next right now. It's 11:30.
Dennis and Judy show. No less than 7 films at this year's Sundance Film Festival were shot in New Jersey. And they're all being released currently. What was shot by you, a TV show or a movie? You know what movie, Judy, I remember was shot here that I really enjoyed?
What?
The Wrestler.
Yeah, I never saw that, but I heard so much good about it.
I think you would like it.
Yeah, so many people love that movie.
Mickey Rourke was, and he was great in it, but it was, the locations are amazing. Asbury Park Convention Hall, a Bayonne, a supermarket in Bayonne, Dover, Elizabeth, Frenchie's Bar and Grill, Garfield, Hasbrook Heights, Linden, Martha Washington Apartments, Rahway, RWJ University Hospital, Stiletto, I think that was at a strip club. Because, you know, Marissa Tomei played a stripper.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she looked good. Well, it was 2009.
I'm sure she did. Yeah. She's beautiful. So what was shot near you? What TV or movie, TV show or movie was shot near you in New Jersey? Tell us about it. 1-800-283-101.5 is the number. Rich is in Princeton. Hi, Rich. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Good.
Can you hear me okay?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So back in early 2000, they shot a movie in La Valette. We had a house down there, and it was called Greetings from the Shore. Kim Shaw was in it. J.O. Sanders was in it. And I can't remember the other guy's name. Anyway, but it was a good feel-good kind of movie. But what they did with us was they used our house for the production. They used to do all the makeup and everything in there. And we got to be in the movie as extras.
Wow.
That's so... Oh, so your house wasn't actually in it, but it was like they used it... That's funny. Sometimes they rent a house in the neighborhood just for people to like stay in or to do makeup in. I forgot about that.
What was the movie again, Rich?
That's exactly it. Greetings from the Shore.
Yeah. What year?
Early 2000s.
All right. Worth watching?
Yeah, it was good. Chick flick kind of movie, but yeah, it was good.
All right.
It was Kim Shaw made her kind of debut in that one. It was one of her first movies.
Who is that?
Kim Shaw? You don't know Kim Shaw? Kim Shaw.
I felt like I should know her.
Yeah.
Kim Shaw made her debut in that.
Yeah. Huh. Thank you, Rich. Appreciate the call.
And look at her now.
Yeah.
Look at her now,
right.
Dennis.
Well, did you see her speech at the Golden Globes?
I did not, no. But she accepted that... political appointment.
Right. Well, briefly. Yeah, but she didn't stay long.
Well, with the all the press problems she had.
And of course, she was going through that divorce at the time.
That was rough. A lot of bad gossip surrounding the whole thing with the adoption, the kids. And who is she again? Because we're totally making it. Never
mind. I'm looking at her face. She's pretty. She's a Canadian actress. Canadian-born American actress.
She must have been in something that this guy's bragging about it.
Best known as Dr. Cassie Williams on Saving Hope, which was 2015 to 2017.
Kim Shaw. That's a real actress.
Yeah. All right. Corey is calling from Warren County. Hi, Corey.
Hey, how are you guys?
We're great. How are you?
By the way, this is Corey from Warren County's debut, just so you know.
Got a start here. Right.
This is where he got his start officially. Yeah.
So, Corey, what do you got?
The movie predates me, but Friday the 13th was filmed where I grew up.
What town?
Blairstown, New Jersey.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, Friday the 13th, yeah, it predates me. It was a source of behavior control for all the young kids growing up. Jason was threatened if we didn't act right growing up.
Really? He would come out of the wherever he was hiding in Blairstown?
Yeah, older siblings and cousins used to torture us, and then I did it as I got older to my younger siblings and cousins.
What a lovely local tradition.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it was fun growing up. Scared the crap out of us, but it worked.
Very good. All right, Corey, thanks for that. Denise is in Mount Olive. You're on New Jersey 101.5. Hi, Denise.
Hi, how are you guys?
Good, how are you? Thank you.
So my husband grew up in Newark, Iron Bound Section, Ferry Street, War of the Worlds with Tom Cruise, was filmed on that street as well at the Four Corners Church that's at the top of Ferry Street.
Now that wasn't out too long ago, right?
I don't know exactly the year. He was in that apartment since 74, so,
wow.
And his mom still lives there today. So when you see the one scene with the aliens coming in and they're running through the side street, you can actually look in the distance and see my husband's bedroom.
Wow.
That's so cute.
Yeah, it was 2005. I thought it was more recent than that. It was 2005, War of the Worlds.
Yeah.
Very good.
And the church up on the Five Corners up there was where all the asphalt got lifted up and everyone went underneath the street at one point and tried to avoid that.
Thank you, Denise. Judy, during Christmas, there was I wrote a post about it. There was a Home Alone tour of New York City, or an Elf tour. There was a tour of the scenes shot in New York City in Elf.
That's like my kid's favorite movie.
And so, and you sign up for $25 or whatever, and they take you to here and there and wherever it is shot. We should do a Jersey film tour.
There's already one for Sopranos. There's a couple of guys who do it.
But I'm sure if you take all these different films, you could...
Right, like if you did one for all different things.
Mob movies.
Right.
Horror movies.
Yeah, because it would have to be... Like Sopranos, it would have to be some kind of iconic movie. There's a guy who does like Kevin Smith movies.
Yeah, I'm sure there's enough for everybody.
And by the way, speaking of Kevin Smith movies, I tried to watch Mallrats the other day because I was like, you know what? I'm a Jersey person. Right. I should really... Couldn't.
And what was the other one? A convenience store or the Clerks? Clerks, was that his?
Clerks. And then there was also the one that his store is named after. Ted and something.
Oh, Great Adventure. Ted and...
Ted and somebody's something.
Yeah, I watched a little bit of that. Stupid. But yeah, I'm also one of the people not invited to his party.
Yeah, I'm not. Well, it's for a different generation. Demographic.
Yeah. All right. It's 11:44. Fast traffic and your call coming up. And I want to tell you about the tub cut. Do your parents find it difficult to step over to the bathtub to take a shower? Well, your worries are over. Dennis Malloy here. I wanted to tell you about the tub cut, which converts your tub into a walk-in shower without costly renovation. It's custom fabricated to meet your needs, completed in just half a day. It's even reversible for when you go to sell your home. Just a 4-inch step. No more struggling to get in and out. You avoid serious injuries with improved safety and accessibility. My parents had something similar to this done a few years ago, and it was life-changing. Now it's less costly and less invasive. You'll love them. Great people. Call them today, 877-TUB-CUTS, or log on to tubcut.com. Dennis and Judy Show, 11:52. It looks like it'll be ending earlier by you, Judy, than by me. It's going to be ending from north to south around 5 o'clock-ish.
So, oh, really?
Yeah. You're hunkered down for tonight anyway, right?
Well, I was going to go to that appointment, but I'm going to cancel it just because, I want to wait. What?
It'll still be snowing by 2:30.
I know. That's why I'm like, let me just wait until everything is whatever. That's not an important appointment.
Okay. So what was shot in your town TV show or film? 7 films at the Sundance Film Festival this year were shot in New Jersey. Tons of stuff shot here. We've got every kind of location you could possibly want.
Why did you say film? Because do you know that my husband says that unironically?
Well, I just say, like I say, Manalapan, ironically, film.
No, because film, I mean, there's actually... people who say that. New York
is that a New York thing?
Brooklyn people say film, and it's so annoying. And he's not kidding.
It's cute. I didn't know.
I don't find it cute.
Mike, you probably did when you first started dating him.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. There was a lot of things that were very cute when we first started dating.
And now?
I want to shoot myself in the face.
Mike. No, can we do an hour? I know
everything
love him
is
dearly.
Cute on him, really.
Can we do an hour of the things?
Some things that aren't so cute.
The things you thought were cute when you first met your significant other that now drive you insane.
You know what he always does? He'll say something, and then I'll just say, "Really?" Because I think it's whatever. And he goes, "Okay, sorry, I spoke."
Does that bother you?
No, but it's just. It's hysterical. And I try to say, no, I'm not trying it, whatever. But, you know, he knows that I'm always right. So if I'm going to disagree with him, he just, sorry I spoke, because he knows
that's a good
I don't
out.
Even try.
That's a good way to deal with it. Mike is in Stewartsville. Hey, Mike.
How you doing?
Good.
They made a movie about a friend of mine, and part of it was filmed in New Jersey. The movie, name of the movie is The Greatest Beer Run Ever.
The Greatest Beer Run Ever.
Yeah, it's playing on Apple TV now.
What year was it filmed?
I think it was filmed maybe 2 or 3 years ago, and part of it was filmed in Jersey City, but it was actually supposed to be the Inwood section of Manhattan.
Worth looking up?
Excuse me?
Is it worth checking out?
Oh, yeah, it's a good movie. Russell Crowe's in it. Bill Murray, Zac Efron plays. About Chickie Donahue. Yeah,
that's a big cast. Greatest Beer Run Ever. All right, thank you, Mike.
Right. Okay.
Take care. All right. See you.
I'm gonna rent it tonight, Dennis.
That's right up your alley. Well, Bill Murray, Russell Crowe. Zac Efron. Hey.
Decent.
Mike is in Clark. Mike, real quick, I got about 30 seconds.
How you doing? In the back in the 70s, there was a film. It was called.
That one. I saw that in the theater, and then I rented it later.
Very good.
Really?
Yeah. What the F are you talking about? What was it called?
King of the Gypsies.
King of the Gypsies.
Oh, yeah.
Who starred in that?
That was Eric Roberts.
Yeah. Oh. Eric Roberts, Annette O'Toole, Shelley Winter, Susan Sarandon, Brooke Shields, bunch of people.
Wow. Very good. Shot in Clark?
No. This was in Hillside. I grew up in Hillside.
Very good.
Like a burial where, you know, everybody went there, you know, trying to get in to be an extra in the movie. And, yeah, my parents wouldn't let me go.
Oh, cool. Cool story. Thank you, Mike. Appreciate the call. Eric Roberts was in the movie that we had a cameo in, Judy.
That's right.
West End. And at the end of the movie, it was a mob movie. And at the end of the movie, the guy's driving out of town.
I forgot about that.
Yeah, and he has the Dennis and Judy show on New Jersey 101.5.
Thank God for those residual checks, or I would be having a hard time surviving today.
Yeah, same here.
Yeah.
I wish. Next hour, 10 winners will receive $20 worth of New Jersey Lottery scratch-off tickets. The New Jersey Lottery, anything can happen in Jersey. Dennis Malloy here, and I want to tell you about Brightview Senior Living. They offer a variety of vibrant senior living communities. Residents can enjoy true independent living while relaxing with friends at happy hour, enjoying chef-prepared delicious meals, and more. And they've also been recognized by U.S. News & World Report for the best independent living, best assisted living, and best memory care in 2023. Get peace of mind with Brightview Senior Living, now open in Eatontown and coming soon to Homedale. Visit brightviewnewjersey.com to learn. Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app, New Jersey. Chime time is 12:09. It's the Dennis and Judy show, keeping you company on this snowy, slippery day. You won't have to go it alone. You have us.
Oh, yeah. We're like a warm hug on a cold day.
Kyle thought don't go it alone didn't make sense. So I just tried to incorporate, you won't have to go it alone.
Oh, he never heard that expression?
No. And the language is changing and evolving.
I know. You're talking about a guy who says on accident. What can I tell you?
Right. And
that say it all?
What's the other one? Based off.
Yeah, but that one, I told you, can kind of make sense.
Yeah, no? I see what you're saying. Yeah. Well, listen, kids, this hour, 10 winners will receive $20 worth of New Jersey Lottery scratch-off tickets. The New Jersey Lottery, anything can happen in Jersey. All right, so since we have I heard the governor from another state, well, from our state, but announced from other states that we have a state of emergency here due to the weather. That's what I've heard. So we thought, well, why don't we do weather trivia today?
That's a great idea.
And Judy knows weather better than anyone.
Thank you, Dennis. I mean, I'm just going to be a little modest about this, but based off some of the questions I'm coming up with for you, I mean, I knew a lot of these answers, okay, and I don't think you're going to know.
Really? Okay, yeah. Well, I feel challenged.
Yeah.
All right. So let's get Marianne from Springfield on the line. Marianne, are you nervous?
Yes.
Why? You know, Judy, you've done this and I've done this.
What?
Calling a radio show.
You called a radio show?
Yeah.
When?
Years ago. I don't even remember what it was about. Is more nerve-wracking than actually hosting a radio show. Didn't you call a radio station too?
I waited on hold for Howard Stern for 40 minutes, and when they said, you're next, I hung up.
So, see, Marianne, you're doing a lot better than the actual hosts on the show.
I could never call a radio show. I don't know how people do it.
Did that make you more nervous, Marianne?
I'm going to have to call into this show.
It gets easier each time.
Okay.
The first time when I called probably a month or two ago, you know, when they had the lottery on Wednesday night.
Yeah.
You know, the first time, yeah, you are nervous. And then as time goes by, you get better.
All right, you sound calm and collected. So Judy asked a question about weather. It gives me four choices or three choices, whatever. I give an answer, and you agree or disagree.
Okay.
All right.
Very good.
And that's how it goes, and this is how the music goes.
Okay, you guys, little team here, Marianne and Dennis, which one of these is a proper meteorological term that goes before pressure? Is it A, geriatric, B, barometric, C, tantric, D, electric?
Well, I happen to know this one because I was getting a massage.
You always happen to know.
I was getting a massage from a famous meteorologist.
Oh. Was it Dan?
No, it was a woman. It was a female. Okay.
Because if he gives massages, I'll take one.
Yeah, well, I'd be afraid to get one from him. He's 8 feet tall. Got a hands the size of Delaware. So she said, here's a little tantric pressure for you. You feel that? And I go, oh, that feels good. She said, yeah, it's going to rain.
Wow. Okay, so Marianne, of geriatric pressure, barometric pressure, tantric pressure, and electric pressure. Dennis says tantric pressure is the proper term. What do you say?
Wrong. Disagree. Wow.
And see, you were nervous, yet you knew more than Dennis knew. Dennis, wow. it's barometric.
Is it barometric? Okay, yeah. I thought that was the weight loss surgery.
Yeah, no.
I saw the two of you when you used to do the diner shows.
Oh, yeah. We're going to be doing those again, I hear rumor has it.
Yes.
It was in Clark and Kenilworth.
Yeah. Wow. Two different places. I remember both those places.
Wow.
A while ago, yeah.
That's so nice of
you. I love when people refer to us as you two.
Yeah, me too.
It almost sounds like we're scoundrels or ne'er-do-wells. Saw you two.
A photograph.
Oh, cool. All right, Marianne, hold on. We'll get all your info and send you out the lottery tickets from us two. I seen you two at the bar.
Yeah, it does kind of make us sound like nefarious.
Yes, you too. Maybe we should rename the show to those two.
Maybe not. Let's go to another caller. Barry in South River, do you want to play our game?
Oh, you bet I do.
Okay, here we go. Get right to it, Barry.
Okay, this guy's serious, Dennis. I'd like you to listen carefully to this one because I think you might have gotten confused by the similarity of the words before.
Sometimes it happens, Judy.
It does happen.
I can do better.
It does happen.
This is not who I am. This is not who we are. We can do better.
Be better. Do better. Okay.
Yeah.
Dennis, sometimes cold air, often from Canada, moves across the Great Lakes. Sir, that phenomenon is known as A.
Crap.
Bake effect snow.
Bake effect snow.
B. Lake effect snow.
Right.
C. Fake effect snow. D. Drake's cake effect snow.
What happens over the Great Lakes because the water is so.
Think about it, Dennis. You don't even think about it. You might. It sounds very similar. Think a minute. Are you sure?
Yeah, it's Drake's Cakes effect snow because they use like a vanilla icing with the coconut strands on it, and it looks like the topping of a Drake's cakes.
Okay, see, I thought maybe we were just blurting something out, but now I know you.
Yeah, because of the shredded coconut and the vanilla icing they use on Drake's cakes. They call it Drake's Cakes effect snow.
All right, now that sounds logical. Barry?
Oh, I've got to disagree on that.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Hold on a second.
He's
right, Dennis.
It's not Drake's Cakes.
It's lake effect snow. I guess because it comes across the Great Lakes.
I guess. Stupid, but I guess.
I guess.
Barry, hold on.
Jeez, I don't know.
All right, let's go to Ed in Freehold. Hello,
I'm the one who put these questions together, but I'm so
confused. Hiya, Dennis. Hiya, Judy.
Hiya, Ed. You ready?
How's everybody today?
Everybody's great. Sure. We're in a good mood.
Freaking fine.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful. You guys put me in a good mood all the time. Thank you.
Thank you, Ed. That's nice of you to say. All right, here's the music. Here's the question.
Dennis, Which one of these four is the actual name of a climate pattern? Which one of these four Spanish words is the name of a climate pattern? Is it A, El Chico, B, El Taco, C, El Paco, D, El Nino?
You guys are a riot.
I'm glad you're finding this serious topic so amusing, Ed.
It was La Muerta.
Causing climate change, Ed. Laugh about that, honey.
It was called La Muerta. But that is a bad word, and it was brought up by the guy El Paco.
And then El Paco was the said, famous meteorologist,
yes,
famous Mexican meteorologist.
Yes, and they said, Paco, you can't say Muerta because that means poop. So they just named it. Is it Muerta poop?
Or death, but okay.
Mierda, that's it. Anyway, it was a bad word, so they just changed it to Paco.
El Paco, the first Mexican meteorologist. Ed, what say you?
I say El Nino.
Jeez.
Oh, I'm getting all these. A thousand with
really? This. All right. Congratulations, Ed.
You get one right.
Thank you.
Up.
Dennis, did you know when El Nino happens, all of a sudden the triggerfish come up from the south? And you can catch triggerfish here right off the Jersey Shore. Those beautiful big ones that start to humpback boggy.
Wow. Well, I don't think I've ever heard of triggerfish around here.
Yeah, I was out in the Hamptons at my cousin's house, and we were catching triggerfish, like the yellow and the blue.
When was this?
Oh, this had to be about maybe 5 or 6 years ago.
So I think we're getting another El Nino this year, so maybe they'll be back.
I hope so. Beautiful.
All right. Very good.
Listen, stay well, stay safe.
You
too.
Thank
you so much.
Thank you. Hold on. We'll get all your info. All right, Judy, we'll go trigger fishing this summer, maybe, if they come up.
They should change the name of it. It sounds horrible. It's a trigger fish. It doesn't sound like it would be yummy.
Yeah. And it might, you know, it might send some Gen Z.
You know,
Z
they
people.
Changed the name of, like, the.
Yeah.
What's it called? Toothfish or whatever?
Wasn't there was a Jewfish they now called the Goliath Grouper.
You're kidding.
No, it used to be called the Jewfish. Now it's called the Goliath Grouper.
That's funny. And then the toothfish is now Chilean sea bass.
Oh.
You know, they have so many different names. Like if you go to the Caribbean and I'm like, what fish is going to be served tonight? They're like, oh, this is chupa. And I'm like, what? Like, chupa. And then I Google it, and it's like chupa
flounder.
Is like flounder. Yeah. Why?
Let's go to our favorite traffic fish, Pete Torriello and Mint. I took a picture of Dan Zarrow this morning in his full weather gear. He was going out to clear his car.
Okay.
You know the tarp they use at Yankee Stadium? They use that to make his snow outfit. He's a large man. He was standing by the doorway. He's as tall as the doorway.
Is he as tall as Big Joe?
Oh, much taller than Big Joe.
Really?
Yeah.
Because Big Joe is like 6'4", 6'5".
No, I think Dan's 6'10", or 6'8". He's up there.
Really?
Yeah.
That's not even normal.
No.
He's not a normal person, Dan Zarrow.
But he's the
That's
best
That's why he became
a meteorologist,
because he's so high up there, he can see everything.
He has an advantage, yeah.
Yes, I get it.
He feels the bariatric pressure up there.
Yes.
Okay, let's go to Jim in North Brunswick and see if he wants to play this silly game. Hi, Jim.
Hello, Judy and Dennis. Happy Snowy Friday.
Happy Snowy Friday to you too, Jim. You ready to go?
Yes.
Here we go.
Dennis.
Yes.
This is often confused with freezing rain. Which of these four is confused with
this.
Freezing rain?
I knew this.
A, snow. Mm-hmm. B, sleet. Mm-hmm. C, hail. D, wait a minute. It's never confused with freezing rain.
Okay.
This one is never confused with freezing rain. A, snow. B, sleet. C, hail. D, grated cheese.
Well, grated cheese is often confused with freezing rain, so let's eliminate that.
At your house?
Yes, because we got a lot of it, and it appears quite often. I'm going to say sleet.
So by process of elimination, because you know, we know that snow sometimes confuses freezing rain. Hail sometimes confuses freezing rain. Grated cheese often.
But sleet, never.
Sleet, never. Okay. Jim, do you agree or disagree?
I disagree with...
What?
Well, you say... Oh, so you saying you never saw freezing rain and said, oh, my God, there's mozzarella all over the front lawn? Is that what you're trying to say?
That's it.
That's it. Oh. All right, Jim, congratulations.
Or you never, like, made a pizza and said, holy crap, look at all the freezing rain on here.
No.
All right, hold on, Jim. We'll get all your information.
You're better than the rest of us, okay?
What is the difference between sleet and freezing rain? Do you know, Judy?
Yes. I think I just read it before. One of them is when it hits the ground. Freezing rain becomes sleet when it hits the ground. I could just be making that up.
Okay.
All I know is every time I make a pizza, I think that it's freezing
rain. Gotcha. James is calling from Glen Rock. Hello, James.
Hello. Happy Friday.
Same to you.
And I think you guys, you're like a bridge over troubled waters. That's what I, you know, you said it was like a hug when we listened, but you're like a bridge over troubled waters. Yes.
That is so beautiful. The troubled waters being everything else in the world besides this show. Right.
And you guys are like the bridge. You just get you through everything.
I'm like going to cry that you said that. And the funny thing is, I was hating my partner all day long.
Yes.
And now I love him. And he was hating me up until like a half an hour ago.
Yes.
And now we remember that we really love each other.
Okay. I don't want to cry either, so.
Yep. And now, like Bill Spadia, we're going to leave this song on leave
for the next 5 minutes.
It hits you right in the heart.
It does, yes.
They played this song for me as my last farewell song on the oldies station.
Oh, did they really?
Yeah.
I'm going to make sure we play this on day one.
Day one. Day freaking one.
Yep, Dennis and Judy.
Right. Anyway, let's go on with the contest real quick because we're going to be late for the news.
Okay, we're
late for the news.
Okay, relax. Dennis, which one of these do we call it when it's damp, when the air is damp? Do we say it's arid? Do we say it's frigid? Do we say it's humid? Do we say it's hot as balls?
Hot as balls.
James.
Disagree.
What do you call a damp day?
Sometimes I do.
Most people call it humid.
Humid. Oh, after. All right.
Not arid, well, not frigid.
I'm looking for summer now. Looking forward to summer because now I know what to call it. All right. James, hold on. We'll get all your information. It is 12:30. Here's some exciting news. Trinity Rehab is now fully in network with Blue Cross Blue Shield. Call today for your same-day appointment. It's never been easier to go to physical therapy. Locations all over New Jersey. That's TrinityRehab.com. Trinity-Rehab.com. It's a snowy day in New Jersey, and we're doing weather trivia.
It's a marshmallow world in the winter.
If you look out the window, it's gorgeous.
Double the ground.
Really, if you're driving in, it ain't so gorgeous.
It's a whipped cream day. I wait for it the whole year.
So, Judy, you got some weather trivia, and I've got the answers for you. So far, Judy's questions seem to have confused me.
I tried to make it a little bit easier for this half of the show, Dennis.
Thank you, Judy. Joanne in Holmdel. Hi, Joanne.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you guys?
We're good. You have a sweet little voice.
Thank you.
People tell you that all the time?
No.
No?
Oh. No. It's nice to hear, though.
Oh, you're very welcome. All right, here we go. Okay.
What is that?
It was a little...
Sounded like a car crash.
Audio mix-up.
Okay. Dennis, I need you to really concentrate for this one. Forget about your production skills on the radio. This is much more important.
Okay. Tell me, Judy.
Okay. Dad.
Yes.
Which of the following was not a hurricane name.
Okay. I know that. I knew all the hurricanes throughout history.
Okay. Hurricane Sandy. Mm. Hurricane Ida. Hurricane Irene.
Mm-hmm.
Hurricane Cher.
Wow. I do remember Hurricane Cher because it was the late 70s. I was a little kid.
Do you believe in love?
Yeah. And that Cher one? Was playing on the radio, and my mom was driving me home from the beach, and I was scared to death. But I never heard of Hurricane Sandy.
Love after rain, after rain.
Yeah,
after
so I'm
going
to go Sandy.
Sandy. Yeah, that's kind of lame.
Yeah.
Who would name a hurricane Sandy? It's like, dandy.
It's a Springsteen song, but it's not a hurricane.
Yeah. Yeah.
Joanne?
Yeah, sounds right. Joanne?
Disagree.
What the? What do you think it is, Smarty Pants?
Cher.
Hurricane Cher. You don't remember Hurricane Cher?
Hello. It was a big thing.
Back
in the
70s. Hold on, Joanne, and have a great weekend.
Thank you. You too.
Thanks. All right. Hold on.
Wow.
She is
blessed over there.
Yeah. She has got $20 worth of New Jersey Lottery scratch-off tickets. The New Jersey Lottery, anything can happen in Jersey.
And it's guaranteed to make somebody a multimillionaire, right, Dennis? Isn't that what they told us? Oh, no?
I must have missed that meeting.
Different radio show, sorry.
Dave.
That's my other show that I do.
Dave in Hillsborough.
In my dreams.
Hi, Dave.
Hey, you two. We'll be having a freezing rain pizza tonight ourselves.
A freezing rain pizza. Will you
good.
Be inviting us to?
Oh, of course. Absolutely.
All right, here we go with the question, Dave.
Dennis.
Yeah.
We routinely say the rain is falling.
Mm.
But how do we refer to wind? Do we say the wind is spilling? The wind is boiling? The wind is farting? The wind is blowing?
Wow. I hate that. It is a meteorological term. And it's the wind is farting. And then over the years, it came to mean something else. But, you know, I'd say past wind. It's a meteorological term that started in England in the early 1700s when Dr. Rutherford Johansson, who was an immigrant from Sweden, was conducting experiments on the coast of Dover, England, as a matter of fact. And he's a fart. The wind is fart. And it came to mean something impolite, so they changed it. So it's the fart is the answer, John. Okay, Dave.
I didn't want to include that word because I don't even like to say that word.
I know you don't.
But I knew that you would come
it's
up.
Part of history.
Such a good explanation that I had to do it.
Dr. Williford Johansson. Dave, what do you think?
That explanation is so good. I so want to agree, but I can't.
Oh.
You disagree. It's, no, he's
How
right.
Do you do it again?
It's falling.
He was Swedish, though.
But he
did. Like,
yes.
The wind is farting.
The real answer.
The wind is farting.
The real answer describes our show most days blowing. All right, Dave, hold on. Congratulations, my friend.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Have a great weekend. John is calling from Lawrenceville.
What was we always say Sven for the Swedish man, but what's the woman's name? Inga?
Inga? Sweden.
Sven and Inga Ferdy.
Inga?
Sven and Inga Ferdy. It's not Inga.
No? I'll
Maybe.
Look it up. John, common female Swedish names. You could do that.
Hey, Siri, what is the most common female Swedish name?
I don't know. My cousin's Ingrid.
Anna is the most common name in Sweden for women of all ages and means grace.
What is it?
This answer is from rootsnorth.com.
Anna.
Anna. Oh,
Sven and Anna pretty.
Oh, by the way, the triggerfish, I looked it up, very pretty fish.
Yeah.
But it bites. It's nasty.
Really?
Looks like a tropical fish you would go in your fish tank, but they're nasty. All right, John, ready for the game?
Yeah, good afternoon, guys. But I'm waiting on a sunny day instead by Springsteen.
Yeah, I'm with you. All right, here we go.
Okie dokie. Dennis?
Yeah.
Which of the following weather events begins as a column of air? Is it A, a potato, B, a tornado, C, a tomato, D, an Alfredo?
Well, it was the famed meteorologist, Italian meteorologist, Alfredo Giuseppe Garibaldi.
Wow.
Who first identified this swirling column of air when it toppled. As a matter of fact, that's how the Leaning Tower of Pisa came to lean. It was hit by an Alfredo. And he was the first one to identify that meteorological phenomenon.
I did not know.
It's an Alfredo.
That's why it leans?
Alfredo Giuseppe Garibaldi, yep.
That's insane. John, I mean, obviously you're going to agree with him. The guy knows his Italian history.
He might have been hungry, but I'm going to disagree with that one.
What? Wow.
John, you are correct, sir. Congratulations. Hold on. We'll get to all your info.
Thank you, Tim.
Thank you. All right. More to come, and fast traffic is next. And I got a question. If you or a parent find it difficult to step over the bathtub to take a shower, well, then your worries are over. Dennis Malloy here, and I want to tell you about the Tub Cut, which converts your tub into a walk-in shower without costly renovation, and it's custom fabricated to meet your needs, completed in just half a day. It's even reversible for you when you go to sell your home, if you like. Just a 4-inch step. No more struggling to get in and out. You avoid serious injuries with improved safety and accessibility. My parents did this later in life, and it was life-changing. Now it's much more affordable and less intrusive with Tub Cut. Call 877-TUB-CUTS or log on to TubCut.com. Dennis and Judy Show, 1252. We've got a couple of more bundles of scratch-off tickets. $20 worth of New Jersey Lottery scratch-off tickets. The New Jersey Lottery, anything can happen in Jersey. Right, Judy?
Oh, yeah. And besides, we were promised, I thought, that we would have one multi-million dollar winner. Isn't that what they said, Dennis?
I wasn't at that meeting.
Oh, I might have misunderstood.
Maybe. Let's hope. Nobody
take that to the bank. I can't guarantee anything. Just saying.
But if you do win, definitely take it to the bank.
But we are going to give, like, a new car, right?
No, I was not in that meeting either.
Oh, no. That was actually somebody's idea. And then somebody else said, no, that's stupid. So we're not going to do that.
Rosemary, hi.
Hi, guys. I got to tell you, you guys are the bright spot on a dark and gloomy day. As always.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
You know what I was thinking? It worked so well yesterday to shame our boss into paying for your hotel room by talking about it on the air. Why don't we just, like, we could get us each a couple of Porsches.
Wow. You were good at it. He did.
I'll text him right now. Be like, Brian, our audience wants to know why you don't lease us a couple of Porsches. And maybe he'll do it.
Catch him in a meeting again. Apparently you got him in a weak moment. He's like, okay. All right, Rosemary, here we go. You ready?
I'm always.
Okay, listen carefully.
Yes.
Dennis.
Mm-hmm.
How many more do we have left?
Two.
Okay. It takes 2 minutes for this to reach the ground during a rainstorm. Is it A, a raindrop, B, a cloud, C, a basketball, D, God?
Well, I want to go with basketball.
During a rainstorm, because yes. Otherwise it would take much longer.
Yes.
Right? But the rain helps.
Right.
Push it down. I don't want to put words in your mouth. Just give me your own. Sorry. Give me your own explanation.
Basketball.
I know, but I thought you were going to give me the meteorological answer.
Well, I wanted to, but we're running out of time.
Okay. Rosemary, do you agree?
Say it, Jim, but I got to disagree with you.
Oh, my God. Is it a hockey puck?
No, it's a raindrop.
Oh, raindrop.
Not that dumb.
The answer is raindrop, Dennis.
Damn. Hold
Clouds,
on, Rosemary.
They don't fall from the sky. God. Maybe he can do anything. Right. So that answer is partially correct.
2 minutes? He was coming down to...
God could do anything.
Right.
Didn't I tell you that my son had a question on a test in high school? He went to a Jewish high school.
Right.
And it was about Jewish history. He had no idea. So he wrote Hashem, which means God, right? And the teacher gave him, and then he wrote in parentheses, because that's always the right answer. And the teacher gave him a half a point.
For each one?
No, just for saying God.
Right.
Like, so, like, who was it that, whatever, went up to get the Ten Commandments? And so he didn't know the answer. So he writes God, because that's always the right answer.
Not bad.
Half a point.
Was that Raymond?
Yeah, of course.
So you want to do a question or real quick, or just give Tommy the thing?
Question. Which of these is not a weather term? Sunny, cloudy, windy, greasy.
Oh, today's very greasy, so I'm going to go with sunny.
Tommy.
I agree with sunny, yeah.
It's not a meteorological term?
No, it is a meteorological. I'm sorry, I disagree.
There we go.
Today it is greasing like cats and dogs.
Right. Congratulations, Tommy. Have a great weekend, all right?
Thank you
for playing, and congratulations again. It's 12:56. More of the Dennis and Judy Show to come. Don't go away.
Guaranteed service, guys. That is the only company I turn to when it comes to plumbing, electrical, and HVAC. And I have to tell you, there are so many good reasons for that. First of all, I have to tell you, but I'm not going to say that again. There are people who answered my call when I ran out of air conditioning a few years ago. By the time they got there, these guys had already fixed my problem. That's the thing about guaranteed service. They're wonderful diagnosticians. They are so well-trained, so professional, and so thoughtful. They're the kind of people you want to have over for dinner. Try them once. You will never go back to another plumbing, electrical, and HVAC company. I'm telling you, that's how trustworthy and great they are. Right now, you can go online, guaranteedservice.com. Tell them I sent you or call 1-800-GUARANTEE.
Parks Casino and Sportsbook, New Jersey, Chime Time 109. It's Dennis and Judy Show. I'm Dennis Malloy.
I'm Judy Franco. Before we rush into this fun topic we're going to talk about, I just need to tell you, the baby Kfir, who turned one yesterday, is still in captivity, as are the other 129 hostages held by Hamas, the terrorist organization. And I just needed to let you know, what's his name? The Rutgers students who are calling upon Rutgers to pull all of their investments in Israel and everything. What a joke.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right, so it's 1:10. It's the Dennis and Judy Show, and it's going to be a snowy, cold. Well, snow's going to end tonight, but it's going to be really cold tomorrow. So you may do a little bit of shoveling and then come back inside, and you got to do something. So we want to hear your recommendations for binge watching over the weekend.
Thank you for letting me do my Israel thing, Dennis. I have to do it daily.
Of course.
And for those of you who don't like it, well, I'm really sorry, but last time people kept their mouth shut, 6 million people died. So, anywho,
I was asking if we could get some recommendations for binge watching over the weekend.
I got one from somebody that I really want to discuss with you, Dennis, because it's old. We talked about this recently. I'm ready to dive in. It's 6 Feet Under. Didn't you watch it?
No. No, it wasn't my thing. The rest of the world
you
was watching it.
Watch it?
No. I didn't watch it. No.
I sworn you watched it.
No, it wasn't me. So the phone number is 1-800-283-1015. I mean, it was critically acclaimed.
Leeds?
People loved it. No.
Didn't you watch one of those?
Nope.
When I was watching Breaking Bad, you were watching something else.
Probably episodes.
The Wire?
No, I never watched that either.
You own a TV?
No. I was repossessed in the early teens, 2013, I think it was.
You can make fun of me. I didn't watch The Sopranos till like 2 months ago.
Right. All the big things that everybody was into, I didn't jump on the bandwagon. It was a big, big one about 10 years ago, maybe more. About zombies, I think, the zombie one.
I don't know, because if it was about zombies, Living Dead? You know I didn't watch it.
Living Dead, something
like that? Walking Dead.
Walking Dead. Those are movies? Some TV show that was end of the world type.
The Walking Dead?
I don't know.
Sounds like, wait, there wasn't anything called The Walking Dead?
Yeah. But
sounds like a zombie thing to me.
But what would you recommend? I like, here's my thing. I like uplifting. I like fun. I like light. If it's heavy.
You ever like action?
I like action. Here, I just recently watched an action adventure series.
Okay.
There was a mystery and it was very good. I watched it last week with my daughter.
Tell me.
Fool Me Once.
Oh, I tried to watch it because it's
a,
you
it's a British
it.
Yeah, it's a British series.
So my husband's, you know him. I can't watch it. I said, honey, it's English. I don't understand what they think. I said, but if you watch it for 10 minutes, you'll get the British.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree with him in that it's a little annoying. You guys invented the language and then you bend it all up with
Maybe they invented it that way.
They didn't. An R is pronounced R, not How do you do that? How do you invent something and then the people who you tried to colonize, hello, we improved it by pronouncing the letters properly. And you people with your broken teeth, maybe that's why.
It's all the rock chewing.
Sorry.
So
I liked it. I liked it. And I'm sorry Mark didn't hang in there.
Okay.
Fool Me Once.
6 feet under. I have Where the Buffalo Roam.
Mm.
Weeds.
Where the Buffalo Roam. That's a movie, right? We were told that was very good. We did that a few weeks ago.
Oh, so we're not doing movies.
Yeah.
I want a series that I can binge.
You can only binge when Mark's not around because he doesn't like anything.
That's so not true. He loved.
I told you watch episodes.
He liked more than you did.
Yeah, I know. But he didn't like episodes. You had a bail after one or a couple episodes.
I had a bail on episodes. I had a bail on because of him. Well, here's the thing. It's like us with food, too, though. I'll eat anything.
And he's particular.
And he's very picky. So, but also, he's right about one thing. A lot of these bingeable things are the same thing every episode, just in different rooms.
Right.
You know?
I'm telling you, I like light and I like funny, and I thought Episodes was a great series. It was in the mid-teens. It lasted for 5 series.
Okay, I'm writing it down. Maybe
what's his name? Matt LeBlanc. Brilliant. He plays himself as an egotistical, narcissistic, sex-crazed maniac who's got apparently a large member.
I know one that you and I agree on.
What?
Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Oh, God, yeah. All right, 1-800-283-1015 is the phone number. What recommendations for watching this weekend? I'm going to accept movies as well, Judy.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. You can't call that binging.
Well, if you got 3-4 movies in a row, that's binging.
No, but I like the ones where you can't wait to get back to the TV because you got to watch the next episode, and you're like, just one more.
Yeah, see, I like, you know, all right, give me 90 minutes of something, and then let me go do something else. And then tomorrow I'll watch the next movie. I'm accepting both. Sonny on the Parkway agrees with you, Judy, about 6 feet under.
Well, I don't know anything about 6 feet under.
I know,
people
but
told
she
me to watch it.
She agrees with you. Hi, Sonny.
Hello?
Hi.
Oh, hi, Dennis. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good afternoon. Good snowy day.
Yes. Where are you?
I am on the Parkway.
Are you driving or is your husband driving?
I'm driving.
Okay.
I have a couple of ex-husbands. No husband right now.
Wow.
Except, great boyfriend, though.
Oh, good.
Yeah. But anyway, he and I binge a lot of stuff. And you like light and airy. This show is so fantastic. You're going to love it. It's called A Louder Milk.
Oh, yeah.
I started it, too.
So funny.
I started it, too.
It's funny that you started it also, Dan.
Just this week. My daughter enjoyed it. I was like, meh.
I was meh on it, too.
Yeah, and it's the guy.
It's a little much.
The actor, he was in Sex and the City.
It was Burger.
Yes. Burger.
He broke up with her in a poster.
You know what big movie he was in? He...
What?
Made him famous?
Oh, wait. I read it.
Cult classic.
Oh, wait a minute. The one with Reese Witherspoon?
Nope.
What was it?
Office Space. He was in Office Space.
Oh, yeah. I read that about him, but I didn't remember the part.
The TP. Oh, he was the main guy. He was the main guy.
You have to give that show a chance because he just gets better and better.
All right.
I felt the same way when it started, but it's so funny.
All right.
But I agree with Judy. Oh, I thought Judy had seen 6 feet under.
No, Judy wishes she was 6 feet under.
Did you see it, Sonny?
Oh, my God, yes. The first time I saw it, whatever, however many years ago it was literally one of my top 10 favorite shows of all time.
It was well done. It got so many great reviews. Sonny, thank you, dear. Appreciate the call.
Now,
best of luck to your new boyfriend. Hope he makes the cut.
Dan, Loudermilk. I'm glad you brought that up because I need your help with this one. Was it trying too hard? Because the writers are just like some of my favorite people. It's one of the Farrelly brothers.
Here's the problem I think it had. This sounds prejudiced.
What?
Or it's not racist because they're all white people. The location is supposed to be set in Seattle.
Right.
It's shot in Vancouver, Canada, just across the border.
Okay.
95% of the actors are Canadian.
Okay.
And as I'm watching and saying, this should be good. Why am I not enjoying it? The quality of the Canadian actors, because there's so many less of them than Americans, made it not as good. If they used an American cast, it would have clicked better. It's all Canadian actors.
I don't think anybody notices that. But
you're a racist. No, and I looked it up, where is it set? And it's set in Seattle, but it's filmed in Vancouver, and it says it uses mostly Canadian actors. And I just think, like you said, the writers are great. Why isn't it clicking with me? And I think because they used Canadian actors.
Well, let's see if it clicked with other people. It could be like the biggest runaway hit ever.
Sonny liked it. It was on from 2014.
To me, it was about, I don't notice Canadian. To me, it was about... Sometimes it tried too hard.
Because of the poor acting of the Canadian.
No, even him. He's a Canadian too?
Who? No, he's from Iowa. Oh. He was good. The Canadians blew.
Yeah, but even him, with some of the things some of the lines he would say, and I'd be like, okay, it's funny, but this could never happen. I don't know.
I'm right with you.
Mark would like it because he knows a lot about that world.
Right.
You know?
Vancouver. All right, Jeff, Harry, Lucille, hang on. It's 119, huh? Dennis and Judy show, talking about viewing recommendations for the weekend, since it will be cold. And most people will be snuggled up under a blanket by the fire and the telly.
I'll be snuggling. That's for sure.
What do you have for us? 1-800-283-1015. Jeff in New Egypt. Hey, Jeff.
Hello.
How are you?
Hello.
Good. I'll just answer for him.
Okay. So, Jeff, what's your recommendation for watching over the weekend?
Argo.
The TV series or the movie?
It's the TV series. It's in its fifth season. Really good. It has John Hamm in it this season.
Okay.
And really good. It's 10 episodes, so it's a little long binge watch, but it's really good.
All right. And have you ever seen the movie?
Yes.
Yeah.
I saw the movie, and then they did the first series, and now they're in the fifth season.
Very good.
And each one's been different. It's really good.
Okay.
But that's another one that people told me it's... You have to really take a while before you can get into it. It takes a while.
Really? All right, Jeff, thank you. Appreciate the go. That doesn't sound
get
like
me
Mark.
Right away.
Doesn't sound like Mark will hang in there for that. I thought episodes got me right away, but...
Wait, why do you think he didn't like it?
Episodes?
Yeah. I don't think that's the one that he didn't like. You know what he didn't like?
What?
The one that you told us about, a family who on a beach... And you said there's hot girls and...
Family on the beach, hot girls.
Yes, and they were underwater. One guy was... Some very influential family in some beach town. And
Oh, the Key West one, the Keys.
Yes.
I forget what that was called, but yeah. He didn't like that one.
That's the one he didn't like. I don't think we ever watched episodes.
It's funny. I love it. It's my favorite TV show.
You must, because you talk about it all the time like it's the only show you've ever seen.
A movie, if you want a sleeper movie, it's cute, it's fun. The Way Back.
Oh, I love that movie.
Did you?
Ah, oh, you turned his, me on to that.
Sam,
movie,
what's his name? And he's become a star since
Sam,
then.
Elliot.
Elliot, no.
Waterston.
No. I'll look it up. People are yelling at the radio. Sam. I love it. But I just thought it was a cute movie. No one had ever heard of it. It's kind of cute. All right. My daughter made me watch a movie the other night, Brothers from 2009. And it was just too sad and depressing. Horrible. I had to walk out and go to the bathroom several times. I just couldn't take it. Well acted. Great story, but just, oof. Too much. Lucille is in East Windsor. Hi, Lucille.
Hi, Dennis. How are you?
Good.
I'm under the weather, but I'm going to talk to you about a movie.
Okay.
I got Netflix recently, and I had seen a wonderful movie two nights ago. It's called Don't Look Up with Leonardo DiCaprio and Jennifer.
I hated that.
Why?
Because it was a political statement.
Well, it was about, I don't want to give it away. There's a comet in it. It was amazing. I thought it was an amazing movie, and I liked it. I like Leonardo DiCaprio in it. Also, The Irishman about Jimmy Hoffa was
that
interesting.
Was great.
Oh, that was great.
Yeah, that was fantastic.
And I'm watching movies on Netflix now. I really enjoy it. So, I thought that Don't Look Up was an amazing movie. I really did. You didn't like it?
No, Judy didn't.
It's not that I didn't like it. When things have such a leftist agenda that I can't even watch it, it's hard for me to enjoy the movie. I'm not like Dennis, where like if the actor's lefty, but the whole thing when they're trying to teach me something, I can't.
Yeah.
And the whole idea of it is, making fun of Republicans and making fun of, the right-wing pundits and under the guise of being afraid of a meteor attacking, basically, it was right during the pandemic. So it was trying to say that all people on the right don't believe that the coronavirus, that COVID-19 is actually a meteor sending to the Earth. Lucille, you didn't get that?
Well, I knew it had that political connotation. Meryl Streep was in it. She played the president, I think. I just like Leonardo DiCaprio's acting. Dennis did not see it? Would you see it, Dennis?
No, probably not. No.
I thought it was great.
No.
You told me about it.
No, I don't think so. I heard of it, but I don't know.
Here's
Lucille, we got to run, but thank you very much for the call.
You heard about it from probably Tony.
Okay.
One of your friends. You told me about it, but you told me you wouldn't watch it because of what I just said.
Okay. Yeah, it sounds right to me.
The acting is good.
Sure.
She's right. Meryl Streep plays like a president, female president, who's like a lunatic because she's conservative. It was just, what I mean? It was that.
All right. We got a lot of good recommendations up on the board. Don't go away. Harry, Debbie, Richie, D'Anthony. 1-800-283-101.5. It's 1:30. It's the Dennis and Judy Show. And we're taking recommendations on stuff to watch this weekend in the nasty cold weather tomorrow. And I think it's going to be pretty chilly on Sunday as well. The movie The Way, Way Back, Judy, was Sam Rockwell who was the star. Remember, couldn't think of the Sam?
Oh, right.
Sam Rockwell, very good.
But I think I get him confused with the other Sam with the mustache.
Right, and that pathetic piece of excrement, Steve Carell, is also in it as well.
What did he do to you?
Look back what he did in 2020 in the summer of riots and stuff. He's just pathetic. So pathetic. Yeah, he's as unlikable as the Michael Scott character he plays on The Office. Worse. Okay. Anyway, yeah, but hey, that's who makes movies and that's who's in movies.
What did he do?
He was bailing people out in the riots and stuff who were violent and causing mayhem. He's putting up money to bail people out.
I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah. Ridiculous. Anyway, back to... But like I said, most of the people that act, produce, and work in Hollywood think completely differently from most Americans, and certainly most different from us, but you just have to accept that's who... I would not watch a movie that he's in, but it is what it is. Oh, and the other movie the brothers that I, it was 2009 movie about a brother going off to war and coming back. It's Tobey Maguire, Jake Gyllenhaal, Natalie Portman. Very good movie, but it rips your heart out sad, and I can't do that.
Sometimes I can, unless it's kids.
Well, the kids are crying because daddy's going off to war. Daddy comes home a little messed up, and they're, you know, snuffled.
Like, honestly, like, if a man in a movie has cancer, it's sad. If a woman, mom has cancer, that's sadder. Kids sick, yeah, I cannot.
When the kid's crying because daddy's not right or daddy's going away, it's
can't do it.
Anyway, let's get some recommendations. A lot of good ones up on the board. Harry's in Howell. Hi, Harry.
Hi, guys. I got to put a plug in for my boys, the Trailer Park Boys. It's a series that takes place in a trailer park, and you might think that, as I did, that it would be in Florida or Mississippi or Alabama, but it's not. It's in Nova Scotia, Canada.
Wow.
And it centers around three guys who live and grew up in the park, and some peripheral characters like the trailer park manager, who's an inveterate alcoholic, and his assistant, who has a huge pot belly and never wears a shirt.
There was a trailer park show set in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, a couple years ago, and I watched a few episodes, thought it was kind of funny. But
really? I kind of want to see that.
This one, a guy named Double A, or a woman, man, somebody named Double A wrote in, Trailer Park Boys on the app chat, Trailer Park Boys, it's so stupid, I could not turn it off.
It is. One of the characters is just incredibly dumb, and you think that no one could possibly be that dumb. But then one day, one of my daughters brought home a boyfriend, and he was even dumber. So that's my real fault.
All right. Harry, thanks for the recommendation. That's two people say Trailer Park Boys. Richie's in Union. Oh, I saw this. I saw a few episodes. I like this one. Hi, Richie.
Hey, Dennis. How you doing, buddy? How you doing, Judy?
We're good.
Hey, listen, the first thing, Dennis, how come you have to dissect all these shows? Can't you just watch them and be happy about it?
Which ones did I dissect?
You're talking about, you know, I think they're Canadian, they don't act right, blah, blah, blah.
Well, Judy and I both couldn't figure out why we didn't like it, and I thought, well, I did some research on the show, and I couldn't.
I did dissect, though, Look Up or Don't Look Up.
So I was trying to figure out why it wasn't clicking, even though the writers are good, the storylines kind of got potential, and I think maybe the just Canadian actors aren't up to par. I don't know. That was she asked for an answer. I gave her an answer. Richie, what do you got?
So I'm going to change my show. Ballers. You ever watch Ballers with The Rock?
No.
It's about a sports agent who tries to get these folks recruited and get to on a football team. They have one guy that they kind of, the main guy, he was an old baseball player, and he typically was pretty good at bat. He typically batted over 600, 683, but these guys are getting drafted into Miami Dolphins. There's a lot of money exchange, and it's like high-end, like yachts and all this good stuff. I think it's a couple of seasons, but it's very good.
Ballers.
One guy, yeah, it's called Ballers. They got one guy who runs the team. I forgot his name. They call him G. Like, yo, G, that type of stuff.
Somebody called us about this show. Maybe I was on with Eric. Somebody called us about this show, and I thought, this just sounds like a guy show.
Yeah, I'd be interested in it. Richie, you originally said Tulsa King, which I thought Sylvester Stallone's face is hard to look at, but I thought the show was pretty good.
We watched his reality show, one episode with his kids. It was horrible.
Oh, it was horrible. All right.
Make something happen. It was horrible. He's horrible.
You felt awkward?
All right, listen, guys. Have a great day.
You too, Richie. Thank you. Appreciate the call.
Yeah, and then like, famous people, you know, be in it to bring some interest to it. So, like, Al Pacino's in it for no reason for a minute. And
like, if you and I had a reality show and we'd be reaching for something to happen.
Yeah, it was horrible.
We'll have the wacky neighbor come over? All right.
That's a shame.
And it made you feel uncomfortable? Like,
oh my God, I felt so bad for him.
Yeah.
And his daughters. They're like, boy, dad's so
strong.
Annoying, isn't he? You know what I mean?
Let's get Dorothy from Bucks County's opinion on something. What do you got?
Hello?
Hi, Dorothy. Debbie.
Debbie, yes.
Debbie, I'm sorry.
How are you guys doing today?
Good. How are you, Debbie? What do you want to recommend?
Well, I think you'll both enjoy this. If you haven't seen it, you should. It's called The Mountain Between Us. It is a movie, and it features Kate Winslet and Idris Elba.
Hmm. Oh,
okay. And Jeff Bridges is in there for a brief few moments till he pilots the plane. But it's a very, very drama-intense winter movie. They both, I don't want to give away anything, but it's action suspense.
All right, The Mountain Between Us. Thank you, Deb. It sounds intriguing. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5. We'll get a break, and then we'll get Anthony and Paulie, two Staten Island people. They usually know good stuff.
How beautiful. We love
good
that.
Good stuff. Listen, Robert Dukansky of Remax First Advantage does more than put a sign in your yard. Rob has superior marketing to sell your home for the highest price possible.
Bert and Lisa decided it was time to make a move from their current home in Island. Choosing Rob Dukansky as their agent proved to be a no-brainer. Rob and his team managed to get them 87 showings. The property was on the market for only 12 days, and they got 14 offers.
That would explain why they were able to sell their home for $440,000, which was $65,000 over the list price. There aren't many guarantees in this ever-changing real estate market. That is, unless you choose Rob Dukansky to sell your home.
Check out his Your Home Sold Guaranteed program at robsellsnj.com and call the only agent we'd call if we needed to sell our homes. That's 1-Robert-Dukansky, 855-350-1015. That's 855-350-1015.
Or go online to robsellsnj.com. That's robsellsnj.com. Or...
And then you can just... Oh, or you could Google...
Rob Sells NJ. And then...
And then start...
From the app chat and email bag, Judy. Just a reminder for people. Somebody wrote in and said, after doing DoorDash in the snow for the first time, I'm on the verge of getting fired because I'm flipping out on customers. Their $2 tips for long deliveries in snow-filled or black ice-filled roads just pushed me over the edge. Some are so oblivious to how dangerous the roads are and on and on and on.
They don't go.
Yeah. But if you're going to order stuff in nasty weather, you might want to consider a better tip, no? And you're saying, no, just don't do it. Yeah?
Both things. Both. Tip better, but also F you.
All right.
You don't yell at people who don't give you a big enough tip.
Yeah, I don't know if he's yelling at me, so he's flipping out. On the app check,
yeah,
Cole...
Yeah, he said he was flipping out on customers.
He said flipping out. Hope he wasn't throwing burgers at him. Hannah says, call the midwife. It's a beautiful show for women only with British accents, though.
Hey.
Julia is wonderful. 2 seasons, 8 episodes. It plays out on how Julia Child became a household name. Highly recommended. I binge-watched last weekend. Yellowstone, best series ever. Still never saw it, but I just hear so many great things.
Yeah. Mark watched it without me.
Anthony?
Let's go to... Anthony in Staten Island, our favorite island of all. Hi, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, Dennis and Judy. So I've been watching a show on Prime Video called Hunters. It's really interesting. It's about a bunch of Holocaust survivors. It's based in the 70s. I usually don't get into any of those type of shows, but they group together and they slowly hunt down Nazis that were in the camps, and one at a time. It's really good. Great cast is Al Pacino and Jennifer Jason Leigh.
Wow. And that's a movie or a series?
It's a series. I think there's only 2 seasons right now, but it's really very interesting. It keeps you in suspense, and there's a good storyline. And honestly, you know, at 80 years old, I think you'll see Al Pacino. The reason why I think he's like the greatest. I mean, he's unbelievable in the show.
Wow. All right, Anthony, thank you. Appreciate the call. You've heard of it, Judy?
I have not heard of it.
Hmm. Would you watch it?
Yeah, why not?
Okay, all right. Paulie is in Staten Island.
And your friend Snuggly sent me a very, very good tip.
Okay.
Put closed caption on with Netflix for the British.
Oh, right. Right.
Because it's like a foreign language.
Sometimes it really is.
But also, some British is worse than other British.
Right.
Then.
Depends on the accent. It depends on the audio, the production.
Yeah. And sometimes they speak so fast. If they really, then I can't do it.
Right. Let's go to the next call. We'll see if there's a Paul's
exactly.
Stand down there. Okay, yeah. Paulie. Let's talk to Paulie. Hello, Paulie.
Oh, I love this friggin' show.
Oh. Thank you, Paulie.
The last time I spoke, we talked about trash cans with the snow and people keeping their parking spots. Remember that?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, that was the last time. So I got a few because I know you don't got much time. You guys got Apple TV?
Yes.
Okay. Platonic with Seth Rogen and Rose Byrne. Two friends that meet up 20 years later. She's a mom and Seth Rogen's a brewmaster. Very funny. Really
Platonic?
Yep.
Platonic.
Okay.
Slow Horses with Gary Oldman. And the same thing, Judy. I have to put on the caption for my wife because she can't get those Cockney accents. And it's about the MI5 CIA agents and it's the misfits. So they go to this place called Slough House, and Gary Oldman's the head guy of all these misfits. It's excellent. And it's okay. Three seasons with that.
What's that one called?
Slow Horses.
Okay. Very good. All right. Thank you, Paulie. Have a great weekend. Appreciate the call to New Jersey 101.5.
Aww.
It's a marshmallow world out there. Please be careful driving and be courteous to your fellow driver.
It's a marshmallow world.
Hit the post there. Yeah. Speaking of courteous.
Yes.
The most courteous and lovely people in the world when it comes to plumbing, electrical, and HVAC are
yeah.
My friends at Guaranteed. Are you, wait, am I doing the right thing?
Absolutely.
Sometimes I'm reading your face wrong. Guaranteed Service. These are the guys that I trust when it comes to plumbing, electrical, and HVAC. They are always on time, professional, trustworthy, so well-trained that sometimes you can explain to them something over the phone and they already know how to fix it. And these guys for $77 will come in, tune up your heating system, and then guarantee you that it's going to be working properly and perfectly all winter long, or they will come and fix it, no questions asked, for free. It's a great guarantee. They stand behind their work, and that's why you can call them Guaranteed. Please tell them I sent you. They're the best in the business. Go to GuaranteedService.com or call 1-800-GUARANTEED.
Nicely done, Judy.
Thank you.
All righty then. It's been a nice week.
I enjoyed it immensely, so much so that I'm thinking, what the hell? Let's do it again next week.
My thoughts exactly, Judy.
Wow.
Have a great weekend. I won't ask you how it was on Monday as a courtesy to you.
Don't do that.
Dominski and Doyle are next. Love you, Judy.
Love you too. Bye.
This has been the Dennis and Judy Show on demand. Thanks to our sponsor, Value City NJ, with 9 locations in New Jersey, or online at valuecitynj.com. Don't forget to check out the latest news and opinions from Dennis and Judy on our free app or NJ1015.com. New Jersey 101.5.